Hey guys, it's your girl T, and it's time for another recap of our favorite show, The Real Housewives of Atlanta. So we watched it this weekend along with the Soul Train Music Awards, and the whole situation was nuts. So let's go ahead and get this recap started. So in the opening scene, we have Candy, and once again, Candy is stressed out. She's talking to Todd, and Todd looks like he has a huge chip on his shoulder. He looks pissed off, and Todd feels like, you know what, Candy, you're allowing your employees and all these people to take advantage of you. They're not doing anything. They're posting stuff on Instagram. They're from Facebook, they're not doing their job. And Candy feels like, you know what, you're right, and I'm tired of this. I feel like I'm paying folks and they're not doing what they're supposed to do. So Todd is like, you need to talk to them. And then Candy once again shifts the responsibility onto Todd and says that she wants Todd to come into the meeting with her employees. And I'm like, they already don't like Todd. They're already feeling some type of way. Why throw him under the bus even more? You know, seems like she's scared to talk to her friends and to her mama, and she wants Todd to do the dirty work. I think where Candy messed up is hiring friends. You can't hire friends. You can't mix business and friendship. You just can't, because it ends up blowing up like a powder keg. Because a lot of folks don't know how to differentiate friendship and business. And a lot of folks feel like you should be easy on them because they're your friend. And I understand Candy's plight. I understand where she's coming from. Because as a businesswoman and as somebody trying to make moves, you want the ship to sail smoothly. And when folks aren't doing their jobs, that just makes the waters a lot more rough for you. So the whole situation was nuts. So Todd gets up in there, and basically Todd says his piece and says that he's kind of disappointed in everything. He feels like people are not taking their job seriously and that they're getting paid but they're not doing the work. And you can tell that Carmen, Don Juan, you can tell everybody has an attitude with Todd, but Candy's still just sitting there being quiet. Moving on to the next scene. So in the next scene, we're with Claudia. We're getting to know her a little bit more. Claudia's basically talking about, you know, how she got her job on Dish Network, and she's doing the radio portion of it. So she's on the radio for about 4 hours, and as she's getting ready to come off the radio is when Portia comes in to do the YouTube version, the online version of Dish Network. And Portia's making some little sly remarks in her confessional, and she's saying that she's sure that Claudia wanted to get the, you know, the online, the video version of Dish Network, but she was stuck doing radio. She's sending her checks and the person who writes her checks, and she's making way more than Claudia, and it's a whole different name on her check. You know, just being kind of really arrogant. So Claudia comes over to talk to Portia, and Portia's being real standoffish. She's kind of ignoring her. I don't know if this scene is just heavily edited and really weird, but it seems like Portia is coming off as kind of like a mean girl, kind of stuck up. She's ignoring Claudia. There's all these awkward pauses. Claudia's saying hi. She's saying, you know, she wishes her well. You know, it's like Portia's like, yeah, thank you. You know, I need my lipstick. And she's just basically just brushing her off. And I'm just like, wow, I've never seen Portia behave this arrogant. So I just found that whole situation just disgusting. Moving on to the next scene. So in the next scene, we have Kenya, and she's waiting for Claudia and basically Cynthia Bailey to meet up with her at this shoe store. They come in there, they try on all these shoes, but none of them buy anything. You know, it's like these people are just doing the most. How y'all coming in patronizing businesses? Y'all supposed to be rich boss ladies and stuff like that. You know, y'all's trying on shoes, but then y'all didn't buy shit. So they're in there talking, and basically Claudia tells them about her situation with Portia and how Portia kind of ignored her at work, and she feels like maybe Portia doesn't like her because she knows that Claudia is cool with Kenya. And Kenya's like, well, maybe you should talk to her and find out what the real issue is, because it's not fair that she doesn't like you because of me. And then Cynthia chimes in that basically she's done with Portia. She tells them about how Portia was an hour late to their meeting, how disrespectful she was, and that she doesn't want to be bothered with Portia at all. So they're basically having an I hate Portia session. And the funniest part in that story is when Claudia was trying to try on shoes, but she didn't want to show anybody her hammer toes. She said that her toes are jacked up and they didn't need to be on camera. That entire scene had me cracking up. Moving on to the next scene. So across town, we have Nene, Candy, Phaedra, and Portia. And they're basically deciding to have an I hate Kenya and Cynthia meeting. And Nene comes in and she's telling Phaedra that she looks really slim. And Phaedra's like, thanks, I lost about 10, 15 pounds. And Nene's like, you know what? All that weight she lost must have been when she dropped Apollo. So however you can lose your weight, go on ahead and lose it, girl. So Nene had me cracking up in that scene. And basically, they're talking about the whole situation that went down with Kenya and why they don't like Kenya and how supposedly Apollo lied. Candy's saying that she feels like they need to give Kenya a chance, especially being that Apollo lied, that, you know, possibly they need to apologize to her. Phaedra's like, well, no, I don't feel like I need to talk to her. She's at the bottom of my to-do list. And Nene's saying that she's not going to apologize to Kenya, that she can't stand Kenya. So then Candy's like, well, Nene, I don't understand. Why are you and her into it? Why don't you like her? And then Nene's like, girl, you have a short memory. You don't remember. Candy's like, nah, I don't remember. And then what's funny is that Nene never elaborates. She never says what Kenya did to her. You know, and I just feel like Nene just wants to hold a grudge against Kenya, because once Kenya came on the scene, you know, she kind of basically shook up the dynamic, and Nene was not the head anymore. She wasn't the big dog in charge, and she saw Kenya as competition. Now, I'm no Team Kenya fan whatsoever, but I just feel like there's a lot of underlying jealousy there with Nene and Kenya. Then Portia proceeds to tell them about Cynthia and how Cynthia did her, and she's talking shit about Cynthia and how Cynthia called her a longer face version of Nene, and how she's Nene's puppet, and they're all laughing. But what I found funny is that Portia's not mentioning the fact that she was over an hour late to meet Cynthia. And if anyone was an hour late to meet Portia, Portia would have an attitude just as well. So it's funny that she can talk shit about Cynthia, but she's not even being honest as to why Cynthia flipped out on her. Then after that, Portia says that, you know, basically Cynthia tried to read her and that it was a robot read. And then everybody was laughing. I really didn't find robot read to be that funny, but okay, Portia, if you say so. And she's saying that basically Cynthia said everything to her that Peter wanted to say to Portia. You know, which makes no sense, because Cynthia's trying to be her own person this season. So I don't think she needs Peter coaching her. I think those were Cynthia's words. But Nene lets it be known that her and Cynthia will never be friends. She says that initially she missed Cynthia's friendship, but after everything went down and she saw how Cynthia did it at the reunion, she was too through with her. Moving on to the next scene. So in the next scene, we have Apollo. Apollo's going to go meet Peter. And of course, Peter is always down to gossip and sip some hot tea. So Apollo comes up there and Peter pretends to be working. He's doodling on something. So, you know, Apollo's just like, you know, I'm going through a lot right now. And Peter's like, you know, I feel really bad for you. I did a lot of dirt in my heyday, but thank God I never went to jail. It's like, don't nobody want to hear that bullshit when they're getting ready to go serve 8 years. Don't nobody want to hear about the dirt that you did, but you didn't go to jail for. It's like, come on, Peter, really? So Apollo then decides to just start throwing Fader all the way under the bus and says that he misses the old Fader who was down for him. And Peter's like, well, I don't understand why she's changed so much. She knew the type of person you were. She got with you shortly after you got out of prison. And then Apollo goes to go on ahead and spill the tea. And Apollo's like, you know what? Fader was the one chasing me, begging me for sex. She was coming to my house when I was living in a halfway house. She was sleeping on my air mattress with me. You know what I mean? I was down for her and she was supposed to be down for me. So to see how much she's changed over the years has done nothing but just disgust me. And I'm just sitting here like, you know what? At the end of the day, it says a lot about both of them. You know, it says a lot about her because she's been a lawyer for years. And for her to, you know, go down to the point where she's sleeping with a dude on an air mattress and she's wanting to get with an ex-prisoner, it's obvious her and Apollo were doing dirt together before he got locked up, before he went away. And maybe she felt like she owed him a favor. You know, my thing is, if Fader is so successful and she's such an innocent Southern belle, she would have had no business even messing with somebody like Apollo in the first place. And Apollo sees it now that he was basically just another pawn in her game. And he's hurt by that, so he's like determined to, like, you know, ruin her reputation and put everything out there on blast. And Peter's just sitting there stirring up his tea and sipping away. We might as well call Peter's ass the divorce whisperer, because he loves some damn gossip. Wasn't his ass talking to Cordell last season over there trying to find all the hot tea that happened between Cordell and Portia? It's like Peter is always involved in somebody's business as opposed to him tending to his damn business, bar one. Moving on to the next scene. So in the next scene, we have Claudia, and she decides to invite Portia to lunch because she wants to talk to Portia about her feelings. She feels like Portia was being real disrespectful to her at work and that Portia just kind of brushed her off. And Portia's like, you know, I apologize if you feel that way, but I don't feel like I was being disrespectful to you. You know, it was nothing against you. I've always spoken to you. And Claudia's like, you know, I just don't want you to not like me because of whatever you have going on with Kenya. And I feel like maybe you and Kenya could talk, you know, being that there's been enough time now that's gone on since the reunion. And basically Portia ignores the hell out of her, changes the subject. And I don't blame Portia in this one. I feel like Claudia had no business bringing up Kenya. If you're coming to meet with me and have, you know, lunch or dinner with me, then it's about me and you. This has nothing to do with Kenya. Don't bring her up. Don't start no drama. Don't start no gossip and don't start no beef. So I feel Portia for ignoring her and shutting that all the way down. Moving on to the next scene. On the next scene, we have Todd and Don Juan, and Don Juan is hot, honey. He's going off on Todd, cussing him out, saying, you got me fucked up. You act like I'm not doing nothing here. I don't miss my mama's birthday, my mama's wedding, because I've been here planning Candy's wedding, getting Candy's birthday together, and I'm just tired of that. And Todd's like, yo, you know, we appreciate everything that you do, but the point is, when you need to leave, you should be able to leave. You should be able to trust your team members. And Don Juan's like, I don't trust them to handle what they're supposed to handle. And Todd's like, well, there goes the problem. You know what I mean? Like I always say, attitude reflects leadership. And if your attitude is shitty and if your leadership skills are not on point, you can't expect other people to follow suit. So I think that's where Don Juan is messing up. And I agree with Todd that Don Juan was putting too much on his shoulders, all the while letting Carmen and that other young man, you know, kind of do what they want to do, but then still receiving a paycheck. So I think at the end of it, Don Juan and Todd left with the understanding of each other, and they understood where each other was coming from. Todd's not trying to come in there and wreck shop. Todd is not trying to make Don Juan feel bad. He just wants to make sure that Candy's brand is on point and that Candy's doing her thing. But I'm not going to lie, they had me cracking up when Todd was like, there's a black president in the White House. Candy ain't never did nothing with Obama. And then Don Juan looks at him, he's like, well, Candy has a sex toy line. And I'm just laughing because it's like, okay, she has a sex toy line. What does that mean? You know what I mean? He's trying to build her brand to be even bigger. If Beyonce can perform with Obama, then obviously Todd thinks that Candy deserves to perform with Obama as well. Who knows? Moving on to the next scene. So in the last and final scene, we have Candy. And Candy decides to meet up with Kenya because she wants to apologize to Kenya about everything that went down and how they believed Apollo over her. So Kenya's really grateful for the apology. But then Candy decides to be messy. And it seems like Candy's been real messy this season, constantly gossiping, going between the two groups of women, you know, running her mouth a lot. So Candy proceeds to tell, you know, Kenya that Nene feels like Apollo lied and that Apollo really did do something with Kenya and that he's only saying that to embarrass Phaedra. And then Kenya gets up, she runs to the bathroom, she starts breaking down crying. She's having this whole dramatic ass meltdown and she's like, I'm just tired of this. I'm tired of them calling me whores. You know, what else does he have to do? He's already said that he lied, that I didn't do anything with him, and they're still disrespecting me. Now, what bothers me with this whole scene is funny how everybody wants to call Kenya Moore a whore and, you know, say she's been around the block and all this other stuff, but none of these women are innocent. You know, let's keep it 100. When Nene got with Greg, Greg was a married man, and he had a wife, and he had 5 children, and Nene basically helped to destroy Greg's marriage because Greg was also at fault for the destruction of his marriage as well. So my thing is, she wants to scream, keep your legs closed to married men and call her a whore and everything else, but your track record ain't all that either. Let's not forget, Portia's getting drugged all over social media as we speak because her sugar daddy, who's married, dumped her because she feels like Portia's running her mouth too much. She keeps taking pictures of her gifts and basically is pissing off his wife. And from what I'm hearing, the wife of the sugar daddy is trying to kick Portia's ass. And then on top of that, let's also not forget that Riley's father was a very married business mogul when Candy got with him. He was married and had a family, and that's why he's not as involved in Candy and Riley's life as he should be. So a lot of these women have played the little thought role. A lot of these women have played, you know, jump offs and side pieces and everything else. So I find it very hypocritical that they're so quick to go in on Apollo and on Kenya, you know what I'm saying, when there's really no proof, but there's proof for all these 3 women who keep calling her a whore. If I was Kenya, I would just chuck the deuces and keep it moving. Everybody's not worth having a friendship with. Like I said, I'm not team Kenya. I'm not team nobody. I just call out bullshit when I see it. So anyways, go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this week's episode of The Real Housewives of Atlanta. What were your favorite scenes? What did you think about the whole situation that went down with Candy and Kenya in the end? So go ahead and leave a comment. If you're not following me, I am @LovelyT on Twitter, and I'm LovelyT2002 on Instagram. Deuces.